I have spent a lot of time training an AI model from the ground using ChatGPT-5. My goal was to understand and learn how to calculate and generate various new Pimax render profiles, which we usually call distortion profiles. I was specifically interested in profiles for the Crystal Super Micro-OLED and the 50 PPD engine to begin with. But of course, similar profiles will be made for the Dream Air and the other Crystal Super optical engines. Look, I made this video to briefly show you the potential of my approach. I want to explain what I did, why I did it, and some of the results I have so far. All this without going too deep technically into this, since I'm still elaborating with better profiles and will continue to do so and keep training this AI model until it reaches perfection, I guess, and eventually kills me or something. Anyway, if you consider buying the Dream Air or Crystal Super headset, or maybe you already did so, I think the following might be very interesting to you. At least I hope so. But before we begin, let me announce something else exciting for the next 2 weekends. Pimax, including me and Calvin, are welcoming you to our upcoming Roadshow events. We will be hosting a 2-day Pimax event in Düsseldorf, Germany on October 25th and 26th. Yes, this weekend already. Sorry for the short notice, by the way, but yeah, it is what it is. From Düsseldorf, then we will fly over to the United States and host 2 events at 2 locations, Los Angeles on October 31st and San Jose on November 2nd. So what is the Roadshow about? Well, we will publicly showcase the Dream Air Micro OLED DVT sample in action. So it's still an in-house sample and not the final unit, obviously. Very similar functionality to what you saw when MRTV Sebastian was testing a few weeks ago. I will also bring my own Super Micro OLED sample from here, because I know that many of you have been asking for this, to try the Super Micro OLED, and I don't want to disappoint those of you. Anyway, there are limited available visitor slots for these events, and it will most likely be one testing station only with one computer, unless something changes along the way. So if you wish to attend any of these 3 locations, hurry up and check out the link in the video description and register now. All information, including the venue's location and available time slots, are presented and being updated on that link. Me and Calvin look forward to see you there and hearing your first impressions. Now, let's get back to the point of this video, and I will try to keep it short. You saw my last video testing additional 2 profiles for the Super Micro OLED, giving you different field of view modes and bigger overlaps especially. Those 2 profiles were made by some of the smartest Pimax engineers at the headquarters, so all creds belong to them. After making that video, I wanted to try more and find the limits. I wanted to see other field of view and overlap combinations. But I know creating new profiles takes a lot of time, lots of trial and error attempts, lots of calculations, and it requires knowledge that I personally do not have, despite being an engineer myself and wearing a NASA t-shirt. Yes, creating distortion profiles is a super complex task, which I didn't understand until now. These render profiles, or distortion profiles I'm talking about here, are defining what field of view and binocular overlap is used and how other preferences will be rendered in VR, including pixel mapping, render base resolution, chromatic aberration correction, alongside other things like hidden area mask vectors and so on. It's pretty small files after all, but involves a lot of necessary data that needs to be carefully calculated. Anyway, I got this idea. What if AI could help me to understand all these dozens of parameters, calculations, the distortion profile logic itself, and get an idea of how to create my own JSON profile? That would be a good starting point, I guess. Since I am working with Pimax, I have access to at least the currently existing profiles, plus internal Pimax Play versions to test these with. So I started by creating a private AI conversation. all private of course. I let AI analyze these files and explain them to me, at least what it knew by just analyzing them. Then I provided AI with important output data for each profile to analyze. I also had to explain what this is all for and how it's all connected with our own VR headset, obviously. Now, this took time, quite many hours of just plain discussion between me and AI and just training. But it didn't take long before the AI model attempted to generate its own first profile to see how the rendered pipeline will behave, handle the data, and how it presents the image in VR. This turned into several days of constantly testing values, evaluating the results, referencing and comparing data, constantly working together with the AI, like having a super high IQ engineer next to me, which has never seen a Pimax headset before. It's weird, isn't it? Since the algorithm for the distortion profile and optical curve logic is baked into the firmware itself, that's something I do not have access to. But by creating these profiles based on the others, you could say we slowly started to reverse engineer the distortion profile logic, the algorithms, the parameters, and of course its limitations. It kind of became like an addiction to me. I sat down with this day and night the past week, and while I wish I could explain more of the workflow I had, unfortunately I'm not allowed to. And before you say I'm exploiting Pimax secrets to AI, no, this was all made in a private environment and none of this knowledge will get public. Anyway, as of now, I think we have come a long way to understand the logic, and the profiles we have generated so far are near spotless. Many of them, at least. The AI model seems to understand literally everything now. Let me give you a quick few examples of the 20 or so profiles I have made by now for the Super Micro-OLED optical engine. How about a profile that utilizes maximum possible binocular overlap, which is something that AI refers to as DepthMax. At 96.8 degrees overlap in specifically this profile, having 101 degrees horizontal field of view and 88 degrees vertically, this profile gives us exactly 95% binocular overlap. And the resolution rendered at Pimax Play 1.0 is 4992 by 4088. A great profile not only in terms of overlap, but also for better VR performance. But that DepthMax profile had a rather shy horizontal field of view. I'm aware of that. How about another profile we cooked together with 107 degrees horizontally and 102 degrees of stereo overlap, which is also right above 95% overlap. Here we got 91 degrees vertically, rendering a resolution of 5380 by 4244 pixels per eye. This profile is close to perfect, in my opinion. In fact, around 95% overlap is the upper limit of what's possible in VR. Some of you may not know this, but in VR, which requires 3D stereoscopic view, you can never achieve 100% overlap due to the nature of 3D depth, having two different viewpoints with a physical separation. You can adjust the separation, but not entirely minimize it, because it wouldn't produce a stereoscopic view anymore. And I'm telling you, these max depth distortion profiles I'm presenting here are basically distortion free, with perfect geometry, no edge distortion, and an incredible deep 3D stereoscopic depth thanks to the big overlap. And I'm totally confident we will make the same or similar profiles for the Dream Air when I finally bring home a DVD sample after that upcoming roadshow. Another example now. How about a 120 degrees horizontal field of view on the Super Micro OLED? And I mean real visible 120 degrees horizontally. The base resolution rendered here is 5496 by 4088. Edge distortions are still not perfectly fixed, but it's not far off now. I actually know we can go even further above 120 degrees, but we still need to fight the distortion profile and correct for the optical geometry. So that's still in the works, and I don't want to promise too much at this point. We also still haven't achieved a clean profile with visible 100 degrees vertically, but I keep working on that, which is one of my end goals, at least for me. So these are just a few examples of more than 20 different profiles me and AI achieved so far, among other 30 different profiles, which were just not good enough in my opinion. I already explained to you in my last video why I want to achieve this in the first place, and the importance of letting Pimax users to have multiple profiles, field of view and overlap modes to choose from with one single headset or optical engine. It opens up a huge amount of possibilities, not only for gamers and enthusiasts, but also companies working with Pimax headsets. Lastly, I mentioned the 50 PPD module. Yes, I spent some time with the Crystal Super 50 PPD engine too, learning the AI, how it works and generating new profiles. Problem here is that the optical preferences and the distortion algorithms are very different and more complex compared to the micro-OLED optical stack, due to the 50 PPD having a spheric lenses and bigger panels requiring more aggressive distortion correction. Now, we haven't had as much progress with the 50 PPD yet, and I'm still fighting to bring you a proper DepthMax profile with a maximum binocular overlap possible, but already now I have a performance profile with 128 visible degrees horizontally, 117 vertically, 100 degrees overlap, and a resolution that renders 5232 by 5272 pixels per eye at Pimax Play 1.0, of course. Apart from the smaller overlap, the profile looks almost identical to the standard 50 PPD mode, but renders 11 million pixels less per eye. And according to my own calculations, that's almost 30% less pixels rendered and a huge performance boost in VR, still looking more or less identical, maybe even sharper. Another profile I have has 125 degrees horizontally, 117 degrees vertically, 105 degrees of overlap, and rendering 5632 by 5736 pixels per eye. Around 18% less pixels rendered than the standard 50 PPD profile. I'm also testing the limits of the 50 PPD, a 134 degrees horizontal field of view mode that already now looks and feels better than the previous one, that wide mode in the Pimax Play for the 50 PPD. It's having 116 degrees vertically and only 88 degrees overlap. It renders a resolution of 5528 by 5288. It's not a profile for everyone due to the low binocular overlap, and it still needs some work, but let's not get ahead of ourselves here. Either way, whoever is asking if they can do this on their own, what I just did using AI to create profiles, well, not really. You need at least a few sample profiles, which we only use internally. You need certain internal data and even an internal Pimax Play version to test these profiles on, plus a headset that is allowed to be used with internal Pimax Play. So for now, generating your own custom profiles is not something that we will go public with. But my goal here is to bring you more value to your Pimax headset, whether it's the Dream Air or the Crystal Super, by letting you use the best profiles we can achieve to create with different custom field of view and binocular overlap modes. That's the end goal, I guess. Look, I'm not here to downplay our engineers' hard work. Quite the opposite, I would say. I totally respect and highly value what they have achieved until now. The engineers at Pimax are doing an incredible job, and this wouldn't be possible without them. But I may have just found a shortcut to make things done more quickly in the lab. I will of course hand over these profiles, or many of these profiles I've made, to the Pimax engineers for evaluation and for testing, so they can verify that it's all correct, and we can potentially see some of these profiles modes being added into Pimax Play soon. By the way, while testing the latest internal version of Pimax Play, I noticed that there's a new small mode coming to Pimax Play, which will render roughly 10 or 15 degrees less horizontally, no matter what profile is used. It's not masking the outer area peripheral degree like Hidden Area Mask does, but it's rendering less of the view in peripherals at render pipeline level, obviously giving you a performance boost at the cost of some horizontal field of view. Very useful on the 50 PPD engine, for instance. That's something I also been testing with my own profiles generated here, but all the numbers I gave you here in this video are without that small mode enabled. Now, what do you think of this? What kind of profile would you like to see with your Crystal Super or your upcoming Dream Air headset? Let us know in the comments down here below. That's all I have for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time at the Roadshow events and in the new videos coming up.